Bhagavat Puran, the key to eyes over Karnada. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Srimad Bhagwatam, Canto 3, Chapter 26, Text Number 55. Ghrāṇād vāyur abhidyetām.
Ghrāṇād
vāyur abhidyetām. Akṣiṇī tasmāt sūryo nyabhidyetāṁ.
Tasmāt
sūryo nyabhidyetāṁ. Karṇau śrotraṁ tato
diśaḥ. Sūryaḥ, the sun god, nyabhidyetāṁ, appeared, karṇau, the two ears, śrotram, the auditory sense, tataḥ, from that, diśaḥ, the deities, presiding over the direction. Translation, in the wake of the olfactory sense came the wind god who presided over that sense. Thereafter a pair of eyes appeared in the universal form, and in them the sense of sight. In the wake of this sense came the sun god who presided over it. Next there appeared in him a pair of ears. And in them, the auditory sense and its way, the Dig-devatās, or the deities who preside over the directions. But what by his divine grace, Srimad Bhagwatam.
most universal form, and the appearance of the presiding deities of those bodily parts is being described. As in the womb of a mother, a child gradually grows different bodily parts. So in the universal womb, the universal form of the Lord gives rise to the creation of various paraphernalia. The senses appear, and over each of them there is a presiding deity. It is corroborated by this statement of the Srimad Bhagwatam and also by the Brahma Samhita, that the sun appeared after the appearance of the eyes of the universal form of the Lord. The sun is dependent on the eyes of the universal form. The Brahma Samhita says that the sun is the eye of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. Yat cakṣur is the sevita. Sevita means the sun. The sun is the eye of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Actually, everything is created by the universal body of the Supreme Godhead. Material nature is simply the supplier of materials. The creation is actually done by the Supreme Lord as confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dyakṣina prakriti suryate sa characharam. Under my direction does material nature create all moving and non-moving objects in the cosmic creation. This is Kapila Muni speaking to his mother Devahuti, and he's describing principles, the fundamental principles of material nature, and presently the Virat Rupa, the universal form, is beginning to manifest. As the elements manifest, then a demigod manifests with that element, and then a particular sense organ manifests after that, and then sense objects manifest after that. So there's a whole description, many, many verses here. How is the process of creation, how things begin to manifest? Srila Prabhupada says in the first book, Brahma Samhita talks about the sun god, and Prabhupada says the Brahma Samhita also says that the sun is the eye of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. So, of course, there's a lot of description here about this process. One thing follows another thing. First something is created, and then something more, and then something more, like that. So Srila Prabhupada said, as I have come here, Prabhupada's mission, Prabhupada said, I have come here to establish the fact that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Supreme in which way? Supreme. How is he supreme? Not that he's not the only Supreme Personality of Godhead. There are many Supreme Personalities of Godhead. But this fact that Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, this is Prabhupada's point. And the Prabhupada always speaks. He doesn't talk about Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Prabhupada talks about Krishna, the original Supreme Personality of God. So Prabhupada said, that's my mission. Establish this fact. Not making something new, establishing a theory. Prabhupada said, I'm establishing the fact that Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of God. And if you read the Vedas, it's confusing. Nicely confusing. And therefore some people think that there is no personality supreme. Supreme is just the cosmic energy. The Mayavadis, they have their idea. It comes from the Vedas. It's a modified philosophy, an understanding. Some people say Lord Shiva is supreme. And if you go to Kalkata, then you will find Durga is the supreme. There's a lot of Shastri reference. You can go through the Vedas. It's written there very clearly. Durga Devi is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It's true. refers to Bhagavan Narad. He calls Narad Muni Bhagavan. We can call Srila Prabhupada Bhagavan Srila Prabhupada. Mahashrika does it all the time. Jai Jai Bhagavan Prabhupada Prabhupada Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada is also, in that sense, Supreme Personality of Godhead, because he is the servant, the pure devotee. Stop all this confusion. Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that's a big thing, especially in India. Most other religions, God is just this one person, he's the boss. But in India, it's a little confusing, right? And people debate. Right now, India, ISKCON is banned in Indonesia. ISKCON society, we are banned by the government of Indonesia. Because in Indonesia, most of the Hindu people are Shaivites. They worship Lord Shiva. And in our enthusiasm, we went there to preach, Krishna is the Supreme. Right? Lord Shiva is something down the lower level. And they became offended. And we are not very sensitive. So they complained to the government, Muslim government, and they had this one banned. So now we have some Chaitanya Shiksha Sampradaya or something else, with a different name. Under that formal name, ISKCON is preaching in Indonesian. Right? So it's like that. There are many people who have different ideas. So the whole question probably talks about authority. You go to a college, you have a professor, you accept him as authority, supposed to know, because we don't know, it's Kali Yuga, but he's supposed to know what he's talking about. Right? He's seen as an authority. He has a stamp. He has a few letters after his name, some PhD or something written after his name. We accept it. Okay, here's an authority. What's he got to say? So, Srila Prabhupada talks about in spiritual life also, authority should be accepted. So first we have to understand what is the qualification of disciple, what's the qualification of a guru, what is the qualification of authority. Use our intelligence, read and study, understand. Accept authority. But once we accept authority, then forget all other authorities. Don't become like a prostitute. You get married to one man and then run around looking for more and more men. Who's got a better offer? Oh, he's got a better offer. I'll change and take this one. That is called Western culture. 70% of marriages end in divorce in the West because the women are just like prostitutes. They're just looking for a better offer. Oh, he gave me one car, he gave me a car and a house. I'll go there. Divorce this one, change that. Right? Like a rabbit, then jumping from one hole to another hole. Should not become like that. Prabhupada said, when you accept authority, the spiritual master, then you remain chaste. A chaste wife. Gandhari. Chaste wife. Famous for being a chaste wife. Husband was blind, she immediately put a blindfold. Should not feel that the wife has any superior quality to the husband. That's real chastity. Her whole life she remained like that. Became famous for it. Developed many amazing powers because of it. So Srila Prabhupada says, find an authority, accept the authority, and then remain chaste to that authority. We don't read Mayavadi's books. We don't discuss Mayavadi's philosophy. We don't read anybody else's books. We take a shot of Prabhupada and we read Prabhupada's books. And everything's there. Prabhupada wrote so many books. No one has written, commented, or translated more books than Prabhupada. And if anyone in his lifetime can read everything Prabhupada wrote and understand it, then he's certainly empowered. Very much empowered. So like that, the idea is to understand the authority. So we accept Prabhupada as our authority, unequivocally, without any question. And then we accept Prabhupada has given us Srimad Bhagwatam as the authority. The Vedic literature is specifically Srimad Bhagwatam. It is the cream, Prabhupada calls the cream of Vedic literature. The Vedas tell how the universe works. Srila Prabhupada said, like when they buy a new car, I don't know if they still do it, maybe they're too lazy now. But when you used to buy a new car. In the glove box, there's a book. The book about the car. And it used to be that book would tell you everything about that car. It tells you what kind of fuel it uses, its ignition system, how to turn it on, how the gears work. But it used to be it would have all the mechanical structure in the book as well. It would tell you all the different gears, what size of gears, they were chromium plated or not. It'd tell you the whole differential system. It was a whole breakdown. It had that mechanical schematic of the whole engine, every detail, how many pistons, what size spark plug, every detail, the kind of tire, how many air pressure should be in the tire, what kind of valve is used, every single thing about it, the kind of paint, the name of the paint, serial number of the paint, how many coats of paint, like everything would be in that manual. But now they're kind of cost. I don't think they put it in. I used to do when I bought my first car, I had this whole big book in each book. Who's going to read that thing? Right? All of that, Sri Prabhupada said, that is the Vedas. It is the manual of the universe. The Vedas is the manual of the whole universe, how it works, everything about it. How many spark plugs in the universe, how many pistons the universe has got, everything about the universe, right? What's the fuel? Everything is described. That is the Vedic literature. And the Srimad Bhagwatam, that is the how to get out book, right? The Vedas tell you how it works and how to work within, and the Bhagavatam tells you how to get out. The Bhagavatam is the only thing, it only deals with getting out. Not how it works, couldn't care less how it works. We don't want to be here. Prabhupada said, this is the schoolhouse, right? What gentleman goes to the schoolhouse to read the newspaper, or read a magazine, or read a book, or have his dinner, right? Nobody does that. It's a filthy place. You go there, pass school, and get out. You don't spend time there. Srila Prabhupada says, same thing, this is material world, it's like a schoolhouse. Why are you spending time here? Filthy place. Get out. So this is Srimad Bhagavatam descriptions here. All process of creation has been given. Scientific. Scientific. How do we know? We have not seen it. But we accept authority. We have accepted authority. So Prabhupada says it, we accept it. You read in the Mahabharata. Karṇau was born with a full body of gold. It was not, he's not wearing it, it's attached to his body. When Karṇau was born, he's the son of the sun god and Mother Kunti. And when he appeared and was born, he had a full body of it. Amazing. Nobody can believe that. Don't tell me someone was born with armor and bracelets and shield. Cannot believe like that, right? Without materially envious mind. You can never accept such a thing. But once you come to Srila Prabhupada's lotus feet, if Prabhupada is saying it's true, then we accept it as true. We don't understand how it's possible. Gadat touch. It explains. Gadat touch was born, and in one day, he grew to the size of a mountain right in front of his mother and father. The being was watching. And there he was born, and he grew up, the size of a mountain, and then told to his father, how can I serve? We cannot believe. If you tell a scientist or a doctor or any fool, so-called intelligent fool in the material world, he cannot accept. So this requires some faith. This means accepting authority. Prabhupada said it's true. It's true. Don't know how it's true. But Prabhupada said it's true. It's true. So this is important to come to this point. If there's a doubt, and maybe Prabhupada understood maybe some things he didn't understand, then you're struggling. You remain in the material world. But if you accept authority, whatever Prabhupada says, this is where we're in this position. We have full faith. Whatever Prabhupada says. So there's a process. Right? Srila Prabhupada explained it. The original personality of God is Krishna. There was no one else. There was nothing else. There is nothing else. There's only Krishna. How that's possible, we don't know. But that's it. That's the situation. Because it's not bound by material quality. It's not that first he's there, then something else. He's always been. Right? When the process describes the Srimad Bhagavatam, then Krishna desires to expand. And first expansion is Balaram. First expansion is Balaram. Krishna is the enjoyer. Krishna means all attractive. And his sole purpose is to enjoy. He's God. Why should he not enjoy? Everything from him, everything is him. He's the source of everything. So his mental mood is to enjoy with the gopis, to enjoy with the devotees, to enjoy pastimes. He doesn't work. Krishna doesn't do work. So he expands his Balaram. Balaram is the worker. Balaram does all the work. Therefore, he's called Adi Guru. Lord Balaram was called the Adi Guru. From Balaram, everything expands. All the world's paraphernalia, the whole creation, everything expands from Balaram. Krishna is free to enjoy. Now, this is described, process described in Srimad Bhagwatam. We're not interested in other things described in other places. Somebody said God created in 7 days and 7 nights. Christians have some basic idea. It's not incorrect if you see the Vishnu Puran and the descriptions of creation by the Christians. It's written, it's quite similar, but some basic understanding, but not much detail. So then Lord Balaram expands into the chapter of Yuga. Anirudh, Vasudev, Shankarsana, and Pradyumna. And then they begin to expand. From Balaram also expands Ananda Sesh. And then Vasudev, of course, Anirudha is looking after the intelligence and Pradyumna. They have their own function. But Vasudev, that Vasudev feature, he expands again. And then you get all the Vishnus. In the second chapter of Yuga, then come all the Vishnus. So then we have first Vishnu. Mahavishnu expands, lays down the ocean, then from him comes Govardhanakshaya Vishnu, and then manifests Lord Brahma, comes from his navel, we all know this part, and then manifests Kshiradakshaya Vishnu, Paramatma, in the heart of all the living entities. So the process, understanding the process of creation is important. Even these details of first ether is manifest, and along with ether, then we have sound, and then the ear comes. And then after ether, then air manifests, and after air, then we have form, air, there's touch, skin manifests, the sense of touch, and then the skin comes. And then after air comes fire, and with fire, then we have the sense of form develops, that we can see things with fire. Mentions here that the sun god, the demigod in charge of sight is Vibhashva, the sun god. And then here Prabhupada gives confirmation that Brahma Samhita says the sun is the eye of the Supreme Lord, is the eye of the Vira Rupa. Universal form, the sun is dependent on the eyes. So first, the element is manifest. The element is form, and then from that form manifests the demigod, or the organ, the eye, and then the demigod, and then the sense organ, the sense object. Okay. And then after that we've got water, Varuna is the demigod, and then the sense of taste, sense of taste. With water you begin to get all kinds of tastes, different tastes due to water. And then after that is the sense of earth, the element is earth, and then manifests a demigod, and sense organ is, or the sense is smell. Yeah, when you get earth, then you get all kinds of smell, good smell and bad smell, all kinds of variety of smell. So like that, there's a process of how the elements manifest. Is also a process how the Supreme Personality manifests like that. And of course Lord Brahma is there. Lord Brahma, he's the secondary creator in the universe, and then he begins to manifest. Somebody came from his nostril. Who was that? Varaha. So Varaha came from
Lord Brahma.
So Lord Brahma is the father of Varaha. So Lord Brahma is bigger, before, superior to Lord Brahma. Jaya Sri Siddhartha. Because Brahmati is father and Brahma is bacha. So when Brahma is superior, then Brahma. Yes? Did he? No problem. You know? We meet many people, especially in Rajasthan, because they are Radhas, right? In Rajasthan, we have the country, everybody is round up. So when we meet people, they say, their name Ram is big, Krishna, later on, Bhagni, first Ram, Krishna, only give Bhagni. Right? Ram is best. Nobody seems to be, externally, seems to be like that. Externally, things may seem to be. But we don't have faith in our external situation or our external understanding. We don't have faith in it. We have faith in the Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam explains who you are. Ram is an avatar. The other day we were doing our stained glass windows. So we're seeing now we have to place them where we place them. Jai and Vijaya in the front. And then we have five. First five windows will be five of the avatars, and the next five, the other five avatars, main das avatar. So which order do we place them? So I looked on the Google, and some, before the devotees, with the ISKCON Desire Free, whatever, the devotee sites came, there was a couple of other websites. So I opened them, what they say. Then they say, yes, Matsya, Orma, Varaha, number three, like that, and then Balaram, and then Krishna, like that. This is the 10 avatar. And Kalki is not mentioned in their list. There's no Kalki. They said Krishna, Balaram is before Krishna, and then Krishna is an avatar. Okay, delete that one. Then we went to the ISKCON site, the Prabhupada's list, and Krishna is saying it. Matsya Purma, Varaha, this, and then comes Balaram, but not Krishna. And then goes through the last one is Kalki. That is our understanding of the das avatar. And Prabhupada said again and again and again, because his mission is to establish the fact that Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. So Prabhupada said many times, Krishna is not an avatar. And who else is not an avatar? Who we worship? Who is not an avatar? Standing right there in front of us. Nasrik avatar is not an avatar. Nasrik avatar is an avatar. But there's somebody else very close to our heart standing here, and he is not an avatar either. Oh, Mandali Guru. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna himself, not an avatar. Not an avatar. Didn't appear for any other purpose like an avatar does. Avatar, Krishna comes as an avatar form, particular time, place to do a particular job, to kill a particular demon, to establish a particular philosophy. Lord Krishna doesn't come because of that. He just comes to give pleasure to his devotees. Lord Chaitanya, same thing, he's not an avatar. Prabhupada, very clear. Krishna, Chaitanya, not different. Only the form, the color is changing. But the pastimes are the same. Personality is the same. Right? And others are, all others are avatar. So, though Lord Ram in the material world appeared chronologically before Krishna, it doesn't mean Lord Ram is superior to Krishna. They are equal, 100% equal. But, Prabhupada says, Krishna is original. Let's get this fact Let's get this fact right. The fact is, Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. And then he gives that nice example that if I have 100 candles, and I take one candle and I light all the other candles, each candle is one candle power. They all have the same candle power. But this is the original candle that I lit all the other candles with. That's a distinguishing factor. Right? That is Krishna. I said that is Krishna. So, process of creation. This is how the material world, the fundamental principles, material nature,